welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Life Routine. I'm back with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you misconceptions about little people. Because in this world, a lot of people have misconceptions about little people. I don't know why. But I'm going to explain that and all in this video today. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to my channel down below. And yeah, we're going to get started. So the first misconception people have that they think little people shop at the kids section. That is not the case. I actually don't shop in the kids section. And people be asking me, oh, how do you find such good clothes for your age, especially since you're a teenager? I'm like, I shop at any store. If something doesn't fit me, like, I alter it, or I'll just roll up the sleeves, to be honest. Or my mom is actually, like, a sewing, like, person, so she sews my clothes if they can't fit me. That's what I usually do. So it's not like we shop at the kids section. Like, yeah, if it's shoes, it really all depends. But, like, for me, I go to Foot Locker. And buy my shoes. I don't really wear heels like that. I'm gonna have to eventually, but we'll see. And there's also like a store for little people to wear shoes. If you guys didn't know that, it's called Cinderella Boston. You guys should go check that out as well if you're a little person on my channel. But that's where little people like shop basically for shoes. But like for clothes, they like shop anywhere. Like I don't see what's wrong with that. We're human just like you, so that's pretty much it. So the second misconception that people have. They always think that little people can't work. That's not true. If you guys haven't watched, like, Little Women LA, Atlanta, or Seven Little Johnsons, or Little People Big World, The Little Couple, they do all have a job. Little people work. There are little people who are doctors, lawyers, teachers, all of the above. I don't see what's wrong with that. Obviously, when you apply for a job as a little person, it's kind of intimidating because some people just look down at us, think we can't work. Which that's pretty much setting like an ableist mindset, which shouldn't be the case. I feel like every little person deserves to work. So that's something I am nervous for when I graduate high school, when I get a job. So we'll see how that goes for me. But yeah, little people work anyway, for sure. The third misconception people have about little people, they ask us if we can swim in the ocean or in the pool. If you guys didn't know, little people can swim. Of course, if you guys haven't seen the Dwarf Athletic Association, that's probably by Little People of America. And they compete in different games, and one of the games are swimming. So little people do swim. For me, I did take swimming lessons when I was younger, but, like, I never continued because, like, I don't know, I just stopped. My friends decided not to take me. I never swim in, like, a recreation center. I had a private tutor to teach me how to swim because it's easier that way. So that's how I pretty much did it, but, like, I never, like, did it, like, again, pretty much. But yeah, the fourth misconception that people have about little people, they always say it's every type of dwarfism, right? The answer is maybe, because the most common type of dwarfism is achondroplasia, but there are 400 types of dwarfism out there, so most of them are rare. So like I've seen that I comments in one of, on this documentary, they say I feel like every little person says this type of dwarfism is rare. So the answer is it could be, because if they don't have the most common type of dwarfism, which is achondroplasia, obviously that makes your condition rare, because maybe there's not a lot of people that have it. For instance, for me, my type of dwarfism, I have severe achondroplasia. That doesn't mean I have the most common type of dwarfism, because if I did have achondroplasia, I would be a lot taller. I would be like 3 feet or 4 feet tall. Obviously, I'm only 2'5", so my type of dwarfism is rare because there's not a lot of people in this world that has this condition. There are. I just don't know where they are, obviously, so yeah. The fifth misconception people have, average height people like to say, why do you guys get so offended if we say the word midget? Because, first of all, that's a derogatory term. If you guys didn't know, that was used in the old times, like, to offend little people, and, like, we don't like that. So, that is why, because at the end of the day, little people could do it all, and we should be treated as human. So, the correct term you could say is dwarf or little person. But I also seen people say, I thought the correct, like, diagnosed term was midget, which is not the case. That's not even true. If you look it up, you're going to see it pops up as dwarfism. That's what it is. Like, dwarfism, pretty much, which is short in stature. Like, there's another condition, I think it's called giantism. It's basically the opposite of things, which is you're taller. That's it. So that's what we like to call it. The sixth misconception people have about little people, they always ask, can little people have children? The answer is yes. If you guys didn't know, little people can have children. So, people always say, oh, I don't think you should bring a child to this world because what happens if a child inherits the gene of being a little person? I don't see how that's an issue. There's a lot of people in this world that have children with disabilities. And just because a little person have a child, that shouldn't stop them from being, like, pregnant, you know? Like, at the end of the day, little people should be viewed as human beings. So, if a little person would have a child with dwarfism, or if they wouldn't know, basically, like, it's pretty much tested by, like, the sonogram. That's how my mom found out. But it's pretty much, like, a 50% chance, like, it could be average and it could be a little person. It just really all depends. So, for me, that's how it is. If I would have had a child, probably I won't even have kids. I'll probably just have a surrogate carrier for me. But it would be 50% chance, a dwarf or average height. It just all depends. So, yeah. And the last misconception people have is, like, why do little people get offended, like, with the little person fetish? First of all, that shouldn't be a thing, because I feel like that's so wrong. Like, why would you have a fetish against a little person? That's kind of weird. Like I said, little people want to be viewed as if we're human beings just like you. Even though we're short, we're probably, like, 2 feet, 3 feet, 4 feet, whatever the number is. Like I said in my merch, height is just a number, okay? And by the way, you guys should go purchase my merch. Haven't already. I'm still waiting on a couple of sales, you know. By the way, I'm not releasing merch, like, more merch until you guys buy it from me. So, we'll see how that's gonna go. But the point is that you shouldn't have a little person fetish, because we want to be viewed as, like, as human beings. You know, like, some people, like, they date little people just to be with them because they want to see, oh, I want to see how it feels to be with a little person. Like, no, that's wrong. And honestly, if I were to date somebody, I'm just gonna ask y'all, so you have a little person fetish right on the gate? Because I'm not going to be with somebody. And if you have a little person fetish, why are you with me in the first place? Like, nah. But that's how I see it. And I could tell you, most little people see it that way as well. Like, that's how it is. I just don't get it, honestly. But it's whatever. But hey, at the end of the day, I know that being a little person is the best thing ever. So, yeah. So that's pretty much it to my video. That's the point of my channel, to educate people on little people, because I feel like in this world a lot of people are not educated about it, and they should be. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys.